I never saw that before, but now I cannot unsee
I
it.
know. Sorry. All right, so I'm actually in creative on this server. I don't want to go in spectator mode because I don't want to look in the ground, but I want to be able to kind of like fly and see what you are doing without getting in your way kind of thing.
Okay.
So first of all, welcome to a copy of the vanilla server.
Much.
This is a test copy because we're gonna do a test run. This is Unlikely Waffle, one of my patrons, and just like I did with Vanilla 2, the Color of Infinity, we're gonna do a test run. The map is not complete. We're just gonna test out two areas that are complete, and then we'll go on the actual server itself and let him muck around and stuff. But I wanted to get a completely independent, what should I say, unbiased person to run through it who hasn't been on before.
Yes.
Okay, so first off, follow me here into the post office.
Okay.
And
That's pretty.
down here, there's a bunch of like armor and weapons and stuff if you just want to find some things that might keep you alive. Okay, so this is depending on how I edit this, this is going to be like chock full of spoilers. Although, if anybody watched my spoiler episode, they may already know some of this stuff, but they won't. You won't have seen it in action. And what we'll do, I'll show you. I can give you like a tour on the actual server here. We'll just stick to the testing part.
Sure.
And I recently had the pleasure of testing your latest map called The Core, so I thought
Yes.
Turnabout might be fair play.
Of
Okay,
course.
so these chests here should have chicken in them,
Okay.
I think. Maybe
They're
not.
not a chicken.
Oh yeah, there is chicken. Give you kind of an overview of what the player would experience sort of up to this point. So we're going to kind
Sure.
of play two of the middle chapters, if you will.
Okay.
All right. So basically, and what I'm also going to do is I'm going to give you, because I'm going to add you to the server, I'm going to give you access to the design document so you can kind of look at everything and see what the whole deal is. But basically, when you come here to spawn, this is going to look completely different, but when you come here to spawn, you are a member of one of these troll armies. Like literally there's seven nations of trolls.
Okay.
And in the past, this town, which is going to be all like Pumpkinhead NPCs, sent heroes into the troll each of the troll lands and stole their wool from the fleecy boxes and built a monument.
Okay.
So like a CTM.
Yeah.
The way that this starts off is the player is going to destroy the monument and then take the wool back to the fleecy boxes and hide the wool. Basically, the wool's got this magic power. It's giving the magic back to the trolls. And the rest of the troll army is like gonna grief the town, while you're the courier. Like your job is gonna be to actually take the wolves back where they belong.
Okay.
I'm gonna give you two wolves, and you're kind of like assume that you broke the monument and you took these two wolves off the monument. All right,
I will
so
try my best to remember that.
yeah, it's pretty straightforward. So over here's the start. Oh, I thought I just heard a zombie attack a mule. So this guy right here is a troll. He's actually a troll bannerman.
Okay.
And he kind of marks the start of the path to the area where I think you're going to give the gray wool.
Okay.
So you can pop his book off and feel free to break whatever you want because this is just a backup copy, but you can
Yeah.
kind of check out the book and then the chest at his feet and all that good stuff. Oh, there's one more thing. So if you hear them talking about keep inventory, basically that means to use a ender chest.
Okay.
So we're sort of simulating the keep inventory game rule by using ender chests
That makes sense.
in the map, yeah. And then, like, we're kind of simulating some other game rules. It's sort of an inside joke thing. But yeah. I think that's the only one that really will matter.
Okay.
And this path that you're going to go on is not fully, like, visually finished. But once you get to the actual place you're going, it will be, so.
Okay.
So I don't know if you read the book or if you want to.
Yeah, I read the book and I grabbed the sigils.
Okay, yeah. So see, like, if it makes sense to you. Assume you just came from this way, so, like, here is the path he's telling you to go down.
Back and,
yeah, this is a somewhat unfinished path, but...
It's at least obviously a path. So it's better than nothing.
Yeah. It gets a little more clear. I was trying to get a sense that you are moving from what will be, like, human modernish lands into this really weird, like, Tim Burtonish kind of forest.
Oh, and, yeah. I just noticed the trees.
Yeah. And then into, like, a completely different, like you've traveled a long distance into this sort of fantasy world where this particular troll tribe lives, if you will. That's cool. Without making, like, a... So, like, the path is kind of open. It's not mandating that you go a particular way.
Okay. Where are you even? I don't even see
I'm
you.
I'm flying up above you. I'm just curious to see...
Oh, there you are.
Like, where you go, yeah. You could just ignore me.
It's just, like, amazing. All of a sudden, you just went invisible. It's like, my God, that's cool.
Yeah, I don't want to do Game Mode 3 because I don't want to peek behind the scenes of the land, but I want to be able to, like, not be in your way.
I get that. Yeah. This is cool. I like the way the you did the trees over here with the mushroom and quartz.
Yeah, like, and sort of all different kind of shrooms.
Yeah. All right. I'm in the... I see now the face in the hill.
You know what? I forgot... this isn't supposed to be here. It's just here so no one goes in that area while it's... Until...
Oh, okay.
Ready. So does it look like a face in a hill?
Oh, yeah. It definitely looks like a face. As soon as I came over the ridge, I was like, oh, that's a cool face.
Okay. It's actually... it's actually modeled after the first dungeon in Legend of Zelda. There's
really?
Deku tree on an island, and I just did it using mushroom instead of wood.
That does make sense. I don't know if I actually played that, but I definitely have seen pictures of that.
Yeah, I'm just noticing it kind of blends in with the mushrooms in the background, so maybe not as easy to see, but...
And still, you can... All of a sudden, just feet just appear in front of my face.
Oh.
I was just looking over here at this block, and I was like, oh, look, feet.
All right, so I hope that doesn't ever fly off into the hopper. That would be bad.
Yeah. That's why I stand close to things when I break them off like that. You've come far, but I can't let you to enter unless you give me a Deku Tribe sigil. The heroes really messes up our lair. Is this supposed to be like that?
I don't remember. I think I might have given him a weird accent.
Okay.
Well, let's see if the rest of it is equivalently weird.
What? What'd you say?
Oh, I was saying, let's see if the rest of the text is equally weird.
Yeah. And we're here in the process of restocking and resetting all of the traps. I went with Russian. That's a weird thing to go with. I should probably have my sigils down here. Oh. Drop. There we go. Whoa, hello. That was unexpected.
Okay, good. That worked.
Now I get all the sand in the carpet.
Oh, it flew behind you.
Oh.
Ah, it's so annoying.
It's really weird when it flies around like that. Whoa, this whole Deku shroom is rotten and full of beetles. Sorry, I can't help but do that voice when it says, whoa. We need to get the wool back into the fleecy box so its magic can restore the lair. First, toss that rotten flooring in this hopper. Then I like that you got a way to get rid of the flooring.
Yep.
good idea on that. And catch some bugs. You're going to need an empty hand and quick reflexes. Just reach down and scoop them up. Toss three of the husks into the next hopper to proceed deeper. Nice. So, so just toss all the floor in.
Yeah.
Can't hurt. Whoops. There we go. Nice.
Oh, good. It's actually working.
Whoa. That's interesting.
They're bugs. The bugs are running around on the floor. So, yeah, I'll let you see if it, if the last
one made sense. Oh, those are hopper, or no, armor stands, aren't they?
Yeah.
That's great.
Where did they go?
I don't know. I last saw one go underneath there.
Well, that's weird. Hold on, let me look into that.
The bug decided to be missing.
They weren't supposed to completely disappear.
And this is why you need, this is why we test the map then.
Yep. Ah. That has never happened to me before. Okay, let me see how I can get over there without actually breaking my own map. Okay, well, anyway, I need to fix that. They're not supposed to get stuck. So basically, yeah, they're supposed to be kind of running all around the floor, and then you right-click with an empty hand, and you catch... Did you catch one of them?
I caught two of them.
Oh, okay. And it says, like, carapace or whatever?
Shed skin and carapace, yeah.
Yeah. And then you just toss them in this hopper. I think you need three of them, but let's see. Oh, I guess you just needed one.
Apparently one.
Hold on, let me go check that.
Pouring over there too. I just tossed one piece in. It was like, okay, you're good.
Let me check. Oh yeah, the over there. That's fine. Yeah. Anyway, well, let's go ahead and proceed.
Of course.
Or maybe this room's not big enough to really appreciate it. I have to think about that.
Maybe. So maybe this, just hold up a little bit more.
Yeah. So this dungeon that you're in now, this lair, I should say, is more of a bunch of mini puzzles, where some of the other ones may be just story, some of the other ones may be like more combat.
So it's almost like a multi-genre.
Yeah, to some degree. I mean, it's hard in vanilla to really, you know.
Yeah.
Get
as much good. As you can actually.
Yeah, without spawners and stuff, you're kind of limited to what's nearby, but.
Wouldn't that be crazy if they could actually make it so you could move spawners in vanilla?
I think it would be cool with, like, Soak Touch, maybe?
Yeah.
Excuse me.
Kind of weird thing with spawners.
Choking on my Gatorade.
So high. That'd be really awkward. All of a sudden, you're just sitting there staring at the ground forever. Guard post, yeah, that says guard post. Good. Can you believe the nerve of these heroes? They completely filled this room with torches. How are skeletal minions supposed to... Minions? What? Minions supposed to defend the fleecy box if they can't spawn? First, you need to clear some of these torches. Then, you need to lure four skeletons into position on those pressure plates. That will get them ready to shoot the next hero that comes by and also open the gate to the next room. Well, that seems straightforward. I shall try to do that.
Yeah, so yeah, so again, this dungeon is basically the hero already came through and took the wool, and you're sort of resetting it, putting things back, you know, resetting the traps, putting things back into an order that other heroes can now come through.
That's cool. And this is right on top of a skeleton spawner, I'm guessing.
Yeah. Do you have a sword?
I do have a sword.
Okay.
No freaking way. Want to make sure I get all the things before I mess around with the skeletons. Okay.
Yeah, this part here may be a little tricky.
Oh, no, that's not. Oh, dear. Go away. Now I'm trapped.
Well, you see that lever there? There you go. Now, I would flick that one back up so that you can catch a stick a skeleton in there.
That's a good idea.
Yeah, because if it's down, then the door will never close.
Seriously? I should probably. Oh, look, a chest plate. I'm breaking two. Aha! You again. Actually, I think I had the right idea before. Hiding behind the other troll.
Yeah, until you can knock him into there.
Forget that you can't just walk them into something. You have to actually hit them. Ow.
Nice. Oh.
Oh dear. Please go in there. I'll hit you with a bone. Ha.
Nice, you got two of them in there. You
Thank you.
may one strategy might be to not break all the torches.
That's kind of what I was thinking.
Here, I'm gonna give you my diamond armor and stuff because I'm in creative, so.
Okay. Yeah, that'd probably be a very good idea.
Oh.
I died.
Okay. Okay, so you got two of them in there, fine. Let's see if there's an easy way to get the next two in.
Careful. You again. Trying to figure out where to break them so they spawn over in this area. Aha, like that.
See, and then I would probably put the torch back so that the skeleton stops running. Like, so you only have one at a time.
What I can't seem to do is get it over the wall.
You should be able to go and hide around the corner and get them to walk over there.
I didn't think about that.
Yeah.
Aha! Oh.
Maybe the other corner.
Spawn! There we go. Thank you.
Yeah, the other thing I'm wondering is, I think that natural spawner has a limit of four mobs.
Oh,
So
really?
I think so. Like, I think once there's four, it won't spawn anymore. Nice.
Interesting. Thank you. Now that I've got the technique down, it actually makes sense.
Oh, he got out somehow. How did he
That's
get
not
out of there?
fair. I think he probably wasn't all the way inside the gate and was probably glitched right through so he could walk through. That happened to me
I mean, it
couple
looks
times.
like by the time they get to this dungeon, they probably should have some diamond armor.
Yeah.
So you look like an absolute pincushion.
Oh my God. I do look like a pink.
I really wish this one was a zombie spawner, but couldn't really choose that.
Yeah, it'd probably make it easier when you're standing over here and those guys are just over there just catching you from afar.
Yeah, try you. Well, because at least with the zombies, they kind of walk towards. There we go.
Yes.
Yeah, he should be in
Wait.
there.
Oh.
Yeah, he
Yeah, with
sniped
the
him.
zombies definitely.
Yeah, now I guess I didn't think about this, but yeah, this guy right here has a nice line of sight to
Yeah.
shoot you. I just hope a fourth one actually spawns.
Yeah, let's hope that that does. Otherwise, that might not work all that well. I'm just hiding over here in this corner in case one does spawn. Oh, no, I forgot there was the other one over there. So I've tried acupuncture now.
I'm gonna break this torch here.
Oh yeah, there was one right there.
Okay, this spawner then, it might have a limit of three. That stinks. I may have to change this then.
And stone pressure plates don't let you toss stuff on it either. Just trying to see if you can weigh it down to, so that you can use items to count as one of them.
No. You know what, oh, it did make four, okay.
Okay, good. Apparently you just needed that one little extra bit of light.
And the one that is on you now has a fire bow.
I realized that as soon as I... And I'm dead.
Ooh. Okay, so at least I know four... Oh! Stop. Whoa. Wait. Give him a minute. Yeah, this could be a little frustrating, I guess. Okay, here's stuff. You didn't die, did you? Okay, there you are.
Not yet.
All right, here, go in a safe place, and then I'll throw you your stuff.
Good, yeah. Okay. Disclaimer, this map needs someone in creative mode to be a guide.
Well, yeah, you would have gotten up to this point maybe with some other stuff. Maybe. I think I'll have to think about that for sure.
I look beautiful.
It's functional. It's functional. Yeah, see, and the hiding place that you're in, notice it's like right across. So if you can get this guy to spawn and walk over here, you should be able to hit him. This one, the hiding spot was over here. That would have been a little easier.
But yeah, that makes much more sense to get it over the side. Yeah.
And then this one, like you saw, it has the hiding spot behind the guy. So I tried to make it like so there's a way to do it.
So it's logical.
Yeah. All right, I'll break the torch for you.
Okay. Oops. Oh, there's the spawner. Okay, you know what? Yeah, that makes
sense. And then we'll pretend you put the torch back down. There you go.
Seriously? You're going to do this now? Go on, get over. Get over. Ah!
He also has a bow, doesn't he? I wonder if I should make this 3 instead of 4. We'll have to see. We'll have to do some more testing.
I think the trouble is right here when I get to this point. Then I have this guy that I'm trying to hit, and then that guy right over there, too.
Yeah. Yeah, this guy. Well, originally I had iron doors, but I was afraid that the player would get stuck behind them.
Oh. And
so I changed it to this pressure plate contraption, or trapdoor contraption.
Well. What you could do, possibly, is if you switch it to iron doors, you could have, like, say, on this section, there's that block right here.
Mm-hmm.
And you would have the torch in there, but you could put the lever inside there instead, so that way you could open the door from the inside.
Yeah, like, I have to play around with it. But I think I like this because, yes, there are places you can stand and not get shot.
Yeah, like this one.
You just have to kind of, like, you have to kind of get a... feel for the line of sight and then figure out how to like avoid it.
Yeah. It makes it a lot more interesting.
I may have to think about this one, but I may make it 3. I may make it 3, we'll see.
Okay.
Yeah, see, and that's gonna be tricky if he falls down below, you'll probably just have to kill him. Kill him with the sword, yeah.
At least this isn't a 3-limit spawner. That's good.
It looks like it's not. I'm wondering if it's a 4. I'm pretty sure they're 4 by default.
Yeah.
I'm not positive about that. So I am curious to see if exactly 4 spawn. Nice. Ah,
thank you.
Oh, they're good.
I needed some chicken.
Yeah, I'm going to break... I want to break the torch and just see... Oh, a 5th one spawned. Interesting. Oh, okay. Interesting. Why don't you put the torches back then so you don't get massacred?
Good idea.
All right, and then you got to figure out where the way out is.
I heard pistons, so I know something opened up. Let me just try to heal up a little bit.
Yep.
Going to look around, see if I can see anything from over here. Nothing over there, so I'm guessing it must be back upstairs, or it's over here. It's over here. Haha.
There you go.
Ooh. I like the way this looks. That's really cool.
This is my favorite. This is my favorite puzzle, actually.
And the items inside mean something, right?
Oh.
Okay.
I can't tell you.
Wouldn't be there when I was actually playing. Okay, I think I got it.
You didn't even read the book.
Oh, there's a book. Yes, that's probably good.
Now notice, I'll point something. Okay, go ahead and read the book first, actually, and then I'll.
Dar, that's interesting. Dar. Now here comes the tricky one. The hero who stole our world really fouled up this trap room. You need to put it back in balance, but be careful. One wrong move and the machine is likely to blow. Yeah, so I should probably not be doing what I was doing.
You heard the firework go off, right?
Yep.
You got lucky. You only got a minor malfunction.
Oh, good. These just went quite sensitive. Yeah. So definitely not what I was doing. Clear out those mushrooms clogging up the works. Once all three dispensers are sorted, press the button to arm the system and proceed to the next room. Dispensers need very specific numbers of items. Don't try to cheat the system. Lights above each will indicate when you're gone too high or too low. Okay. So that one's definitely too low. And so is that one. That one's just right, though. Okay.
Yeah, the one problem I think I have with this room is once you trigger the malfunction, unless you rebalance them, it won't trigger a second time. I need to think about how to change that. But anyway, go ahead and.
Okay. Let's see. So we have a total of. Wait, let me go check the other one. Yeah, I did that. Okay. So let's see. That's 2, 3 buckets. So that's 1/3. Snowballs, that's almost 1/3. Mushrooms, that's. Let's see. Okay, so let's see. I should probably have left it like how it was in the beginning. That would definitely make a lot more sense. And the mushrooms, I don't have any on those. Right? No, arrows. Arrows, too! I forgot about the arrows.
Yeah, so these signs... I'll just spoil it a little bit, because I want to see... The signs here kind of show you which item needs to go in which each of the things.
Yeah. I'm trying to figure out if this one means snowballs or if that means mushrooms, though.
Ah. The mushrooms... I think the book says the mushrooms are just gunking everything up.
Oh, yes, it does.
Yeah.
I should probably read better next time.
No, that's fine. So like this one right here is too low right now. It doesn't have enough weight in it. This one is too low. You can see kind of the thing is to the left. And then like the one you're by the green lights in the middle. So it has enough weight that it's balanced.
Yeah.
The problem is when one of them's out of balance, it holds the mechanism in a fail state. So you don't get, like, if you screw the rest up, you will never have an issue. So, like, this one right now has too much in it.
All right. Yeah, everything's like.
That one's balanced. This one's not, though. This one's got too much in it.
Oh, is it? It looks like the green's light up. Lit up.
Yeah, it is, but so is the red.
There okay. So it's pretty much like right in between green and red on that point then. Let me just clean up my hotbar a little bit because now I'm full of mushrooms.
Yep.
Dear me, that's so many mushrooms there.
Yeah, see the way that was balanced, if you would have taken, you know, too much out or emptied any of them, it would have Oh, the interesting thing is you got two fails, but one was a firework and one was a fireball.
Yeah.
I should take those out so there's only TNT in there.
That's probably a good idea.
You didn't get any of the TNT, which would have been more interesting, but.
Yeah. All right, let's read the book this time first before I just go crazy. Kiss, kiss. There you are, my darling. Give me kissy face and that smooch. Oh, Karen, dear God, I can't do this with a straight face.
Yeah.
But we don't have time for that, my little nightcap. You must place our grey wool back in the fleecy box, and then I will reward you with this, my darling man. I think this person has a severe lisp the way I'm talking.
Yeah, she does.
Don't forget to use your keep inventory to score my talisman and any of your belongings. Now that you have rearmed the darps in my lair, you won't. Yeah. God, this hurts my voice. I don't know why. You won't be able to return the way you came. You'll have to drown yourself in my affections. But don't worry. The magic of the wool will whisk you back to spawn, and you will give my talisman to the boss. Now, one last smooch before you go. That's very interesting. Okay, I should actually have listened to myself while I was reading that, because now I have no idea what I'm doing.
Yeah, so that okay, so the idea is put the gray wool in the chest, in the fleecy box. And then now you can see you get her like talisman.
Yeah.
There's only one other area that that's actually ready for some testing. This is
I like the way that the oil drill looks. If that's what that is. No, wait, that. I have to get a closer look at that because that looks like an interesting creature made out of prismarine. That is an interesting creature made out of prismarine. I can't tell if that's an oil drill platform or if it's a fishing platform. I want to say it's an oil drill.
Yeah, sort of. They're oil drills, but this one has a crane on it.
Yeah. It's really cool the way it's made, though. Nessie, though. That. Prismarine is my probably my favorite block in the game.
We have a lot of prismarine in this map. There's a house near spawn. That's full of double chests, full of prismarine. There's just so much. Oh,
You ended up building a prismarine farm on here eventually? Or did you just
yeah.
find somebody?
Well,
Oh, I
they.
just realized that that thing's chopped up. Oh. I don't know why I didn't notice that. Okay, I should probably talk to you. There's nothing to talk to. Okay. That's interesting. Broken platform over here.
Yeah.
Just one guy trapped on there is like, hey, help.
Yeah,
This is cool. Don't bother me, I just tore the scale off the serpent. I need to get back to the chef before it spoils. Scales are edible, that's cool. Yeah, I like the way that the serpent looks though, that's really nice. And the fact that I can climb around inside of it, that makes it better. I think I've gotten lost inside a one-way serpent.
I was gonna say it's linear in there.
A habit of getting lost in a one-room house. Carving up the beast to feed the troops. That would feed a lot of troops, holy crap. Creative uses of the different blocks in the game, though. Netherrack and everything.
I'm just going to be quiet for a minute. I just want to kind of see your reactions and stuff, so
Yeah, no worries.
and kind of where your attention takes you, and
I don't know why I'm trying to figure out how to get up on top of the island.
it's tempting, right?
Yeah.
Good.
I'm terrible at parkour, but I'm always tempted to do it.
I tried to parkour proof it, and then I had Jiggerbov, one of my map maker friends, help me test it and then try to even more proof it. So
Yeah. And I'm assuming this is a don't break the blocks game, map.
yeah, oh yeah, I forgot to tell you, like, when you first spawn in and you kind of get your role and there's like an NPC that introduces you, he tells you, yeah, not to break and place blocks and that kind of stuff.
Cool.
Unless told otherwise. There will be places where you are supposed to do that kind of stuff.
Yeah. There. Oh, yes. Boats are so ridiculously hard to control in this game.
They're really annoying when they're not breaking on like the wimpiest little thing.
Yeah.
So there's nothing off in the distance around this island, actually, just so you
Okay.
know.
I think it's a gal. That's interesting.
Yeah, at this point, you'll already have been introduced to the fact that there are heroes that have, that are like fighting off the trolls, because the
Yeah.
trolls are, trying to take back the wool, and that there are like villagers, and that, these are the trolls like having captured some of those heroes and things. People emailing me this late at night from work.
That's a really good question. You should ask them that.
So I think I need to add somebody on this island that tells you to go talk to the boss or the chef
Yeah.
over here. I think it'll be somewhat obvious, but I don't know if it's explicit enough.
I killed the hero, which killed what killed our guardian. I don't know why I'm going with Australian for that voice, but I am.
It's
I'm gonna
something
have to.
about it must be the cadence of the words dictated a voice change.
Yeah.
And then each of these areas has a unique head troll. So like the first one was that kissy face girl, and then this one is this rhino looking guy
Yeah.
that you just took the book from.
Sorry, that was just kind of random me running off there. I was, because I remember one of your videos you used a banner to make eyes, and I couldn't figure out if it was that thing that you made the eye for.
Yep. That's one of the things I've used a banner for eyes.
Yeah. It's just really interesting. I've never thought about making eyes using banner.
No, I didn't until I built them, and then I was like, what block should I use for eyes? Oh, wait, I can make something that looks even more intricate.
Yeah. Freaking heroes. They used one of our cranes to defeat the Guardian Serpent, and they blew up the other two rings. We're doing what we can to harvest the corpse. Poor baby. We're not sure about what we're going to have to do about the environment hazard. Anyway, can you clean this carcass and put our brown wool back in the fleecy box? Poor baby. Apparently he feels very strongly. I'm the Swedish chef fish. I can't do Swedish voice.
Was there a pair of shears in this item frame right here?
No.
That's a bug.
Seriously? Is this guy supposed to be here?
Well, maybe, sort of.
There's two of them. What?
Yeah,
Okay,
you have a bow.
yeah, that'll be what I have to do. The other one helped kill it for me, so that's nice. What the heck? Oh yeah, that's definitely a spawner, huh?
Yeah,
I didn't know if
this
it just randomly popped up there.
the pool is there so that when you're close to it, when you're reading these NPC signs, skeletons will start spawning and coming up out of the pool. Just for
That's
fun.
pretty good.
Just a nice little distraction like that.
Yeah. Seriously? What? Not a power bow.
Yeah, and you could go down there and put a torch or whatever, but it's kind of fun to.
Of course.
So this guy here is supposed to give you shears that are and that they're named can break scales, and I don't know where they went.
Okay. Someone stole them.
Which is really strange.
There's a bone in the hopper. That's
Yes.
interesting.
So ba so just for oh, there's another skeleton guy. Just for this, you can put a block in there if you want to close that off so you're not annoyed the whole time.
No worries.
But it works. That's all I wanted to see.
Yeah.
So he tells you to go, his thing was to go and get scales off of the creature and bring it to him.
That's what the other guy was carrying.
Yeah, and the other guy, or this guy's book, tells you to go put the brown wool in the fleecy box, which I don't know if you saw it. It's up on the platform with the crane.
Okay. I was trying to figure out how to get up there.
Yep, that's part of the puzzle of this one. So there's no ladders on the
Yeah.
crane.
I saw the ladders and they started like halfway up though.
Yep.
So I'm guessing we have to go down into the drill.
Oh, it's an interesting idea, but nope.
Okay. I just go to drown myself for no reason then.
Oh, this—you don't know how fulfilling it is for me to actually be able to fly around this world and not have to walk everywhere.
Yeah, I can imagine. Plus, you get to see things from different angles that you couldn't see at all in advent survival.
Yeah, I really love the way it looks when I'm flying around, but I do have to remember that the player won't be able to get up here.
Yeah.
So it really has to be appreciable from the player's point of view and not just the builder's point of view, which is on the ground, so.
Yeah. Okay, so. Seriously? I cannot jump anywhere. I did not find any staircases inside the creature, which would be kind of weird. It ate some stairs.
Yeah, nope. There's not really a way over there from inside.
Okay. Let's see.
There should have been at least one scale in there, though, if you.
Really? Oh. In that case, I shall go try to look at the. Yes, I did see one actually, yeah.
Yeah, so the shear, if you if the shears would have been there, which I'm not sure where they went. I have one suspicion where they might be. I hope I didn't accidentally put them in the treasure that you get from turning in the shears, but
You
we'll
turn the
see.
shears to get the shears as a present.
Yeah, and they're like named canbrake scales.
I like how you're going with all the data tags as much as you can in vanilla.
Yeah, exactly. So like I don't know, it's like this is a scale here on the this guy.
Yeah.
I don't know if that's obvious enough. So that's why
Once
I
I
add
learned that those are scales, I think it is.
okay, 'cause that's why I added this guy over here saying he just took a scale off. He's kind of
Yeah.
got it in his hand. Okay.
Ah, I
There you
didn't even
go.
realize the tail.
Yep. There you go.
Not in, but on.
The original concept for this area was that it would just be a giant skeleton, and you'd have to climb up and break the scales. And but I really like this iteration a lot better.
Oh yeah. It's awesome. My hat fell off while I was jumping across the spine. Okay.
Yeah, he just doesn't have one of those clay pots on his head,
Yeah.
like all the other trolls. And this, some of, a lot of this refinement of this section credit goes to Jig. We kind of finished off this one together.
Nice.
One evening.
This is a really nice build, though. It's quite nice.
And I actually didn't really have all the parkour stuff in mind when I built it. It was more of just the visual.
Yeah.
Like, I knew I wanted to do parkour. Light parkour, I should say.
Yeah. Not crazy parkour.
Yeah. But the path, the ultimate path that you have to take to get up onto the rig is really pretty cool.
Yeah.
And it has, like, little checkpoints. Like, where you fell down just now, it's you only have to go back to here. You don't have to go all the way back to the island, you know?
Oh, yeah, yeah.
So it's like this rib jump here is just a short little, you know.
I liked how you're using the redstone to kind of mark the path, too. Because I can't make that jump at all, but I can make the jump over to that one.
I just had it as random blood, actually.
Oh, really? Okay.
But that is a good point.
Not obvious, but helpful if you can think of it that way.
Yeah, you can go either way, yep.
There I just could go. Not make the jump to the plane block at all.
Yeah, we didn't want to make this super frustrating for people that don't like parkour.
Yeah.
But it is a little... Oh, how did you get up there?
I jumped from here to here. Where was... I not supposed to come up here?
No, you're fine. But didn't you fall off back onto the mesa?
Yeah, and then I came back over here and jumped across again.
Oh, I see what you did. You went from here to the rib. Okay.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, that's fine. That's clever. Good. Yes, you're going the correct way.
Good.
Yep.
Nice. Beautiful view from up here of the rotting carcass.
Yeah, and there's a couple of those up there, so you can't get enough unless you get up to the head. I was going to make it so that you had to get all the scales in order to get to the head, but then I decided I'll just make that kind of a side quest.
Yeah.
That you can turn in and get extra loot. Which isn't finalized, but...
This is interesting. Oh, yeah, I like how you have that block on top so you can actually move over to the side to get all the way up.
Yep.
This crane is cool, looking with the redstone torches on it. Like connectors. That's what it looks like to me, at least.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Yeah, I was just thinking of, like, those safety lights or whatever you call them, but...
Oh, yeah, yeah. Definitely that, too. I think you call them safety lights. Phew, I had to say, courier, that climb was impressive. Now put the brown wool in our fleecy box and take the fishing talisman back to the boss while we get these rigs back in working order. I shall do that. Thank you. Prismarine crystals. Thank you very much. I don't know why I keep taking everything in these chests, but I do.
Yeah, that's pretty much what everyone, or a lot of people will do, is take everything and anything. So we have to really figure out, like, what's the minimum amount of stuff we can give a player so that, like, they have to decide if they take it or not, but it won't let them, you know, cheat.
Yeah.
So.
Interesting putting these buttons in here where someone might not even notice them to begin with.
Oh, it's yeah. It's like
the random... Sorry?
You have to make details, otherwise it's no fun.
Yeah. And... Oh, no.
Oh, shoot. Here. I'll make it easy on you.
Oh, thank you.
Whoops, wait. Oh, okay. Okay. Yeah, see,
now if I was actually playing the map and I did that.
Now on this one, I figured once you put the wool in there, there's no reason to kill you because you can just go down and you're like really close to the island. So I didn't put a death them up here.
That's a good idea. Cool. Whoa, hello, chest. With fishing talismans. Okay, where was I supposed to put the white banners? I can't remember. Or the scales?
Oh, you bring them back over to the chef.
Oh, right, yeah.
Yeah, yeah, so once you get the fishing talisman, you pretty much have done the main, this main branch, if you will.
Okay.
And then, the banners are just sort of a side. I'm actually really curious to see if the shears are inside the chest.
Yeah.
Otherwise, I don't know what happened to them. That's really weird.
Oh, no. Not wood. I heard the piston. There it is. Serpent bisque, serpent key gumbo, and stew.
Okay, there's
sake.
There's no shears.
There's no shears. That would have been interesting if you had accidentally put them there.
Yeah, that was the last place that I saw them was when I was filling that chest, and they're not on this guy. Huh, they might be back in my home.
Possibly.
So I have some notes on these two areas to kind of make them a little bit smoother, but I think they generally worked as intended.
Yeah. I don't know why I wasn't paying attention to this section. I was paying attention to that section all the way to the head, but not this last section right here.
Yeah, I think I'll have to put somebody like right here introducing kind of, you know, welcome to the island kind of thing.
Yeah.
And then maybe saying to go find the chef or something like that.
Yeah.
That way the players are like looking for. And again, I think by this point you hopefully will be already familiar with the concept of each of these branches is like, okay, find the guy with the book. He'll give you the, you know, the sort of lore to get to the fleecy box and then do the little side quest and get to the box. Like there'll be, you know, four other dungeons before you get here to sort of train you of what you're supposed to look for. Well, hey, thank you for coming and helping us test out some of the early areas. I hope this actually gives you kind of a feel for, you know, how the map is going to eventually be. And
definitely
maybe get your brain juices flowing in how you can help with some other areas.
Yeah, that sounds awesome.
Okay.
What's up?
There's a sign here I've never seen before. CFG loves wine so much he wants to marry them. I don't know why that's there. There must be some vines somewhere in here.